I am a gay black woman who is more masculine presenting. So when I, like you were saying, when I step into the world, it's like boom, boom, boom that I'm presenting. And, you know, at any turn, any one of those things could be detrimental to my safety. So, but I'm doing it. I'm out here. And luckily, I picked a place to live that is way accepting. And like Bridget was saying, we have a community that we bond with and we can cry with and we can vent to. And I think it's specifically for me, having Bridget being so much of an advocate, not only for our relationship, but for, you know, my blackness and the things that I'm struggling with, you know, just like the last couple of days, we've seen so much stuff happening to the black community, and it's painful and it's hurtful. But to have someone like Bridget who I can truly, truly, truly vent to and tell my frustrations, I think that she is a part of my self-care in a huge way.
I think there's so much, I know, that's so sweet. I mean, the ultimate, I think one of the most ultimate expressions of love is allyship that is fallible. So not allyship that doesn't mean it can't be educated or that it doesn't require growth, but allyship that says, I will not inevitably betray you. I think that there's so many allies that I've found in life who might be, for example, allies to the black community, allies to our community, that I'm like, inevitably, I don't know if you won't fail me. But to have an ally on your side who you know is always growing, always educating themselves, always learning, that's invaluable. It's something
that's 100%. That is the truest. That's a wonderful way to phrase it too, because yeah. I found even in my relationship with friends I've had for a long time, I like to believe that I would be as strong of an advocate as I am if I was not dating Ronnie. You like to believe in a perfect world that you can empathize enough. Mm-hmm. And I think I would have. But there's probably still going to always be that little bit of empathy you can't maybe reach. I don't know. I don't want to give excuses. But I found myself looking at my own community that I had made before without our relationship and thinking I should be expecting more from some of my people, my friends, my family, and expecting more and demanding more and not feel bad about that.
Right.
Especially as we've grown older and their resources are innumerable, like there's just so many opportunities to learn and grow. And you're so right. Like if they're not going to take that opportunity to do so, that's why we've curated a special group.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
There's no time for that.
You select the time you give to people wisely.
Mm-hmm. Totally.